he would have built that academy a little bit earlier, but now he's losing all his siege tanks.
Units aren't even able to fall out. I wonder how many of them did die inside of it. And now, movie,
type out GG.
This Zerg force, though, looking way too strong. The Marines are going to
This die. Is the disadvantage of not having the dropships. The tanks, once they're in siege mode, can get taken out very quickly.
And doing a really good job here. Shuttle's just swarming his way in. 25 Zealots are left, and a nice storm going down on those tanks. And a Reaver does end up getting taken out. The Shuttle is micering one more Reaver behind this. The Archons are laying waste against this front line here, but storms are coming in. That Bunker is really low on health in the red. And finally, it does explode. The Marines are just fodder to these Dragoons. He's got to micro them back, though. If he loses the Dragoon, that's going to be a huge mistake here.
Annyeonghaseyo. Hello, everybody. I am Patrick Witty, also known as Bisu Dagger, and I am the cast of GOM TV's Classic Season 4. GOM XP has asked me to provide this interview with you guys so you guys could know a little bit more about the voice behind who is doing the English commentary for StarCraft 1. Now, I'm going to read off from this list of questions they have provided for me and give you some really cool answers in the background. I am 26 years old. I am 6'3", 230 pounds, and I'm a software engineer who writes simulations for military aircraft. Well, I started casting consistently back in 2013 and ended up over the summer casting the entire Ever 2007 OSL. So that was a lot of fun for me. And obviously with GOM having great events from early 2000s to up to now, whether it was GOM Classics or GSLs, I've really been involved with watching GOM events. And in fact, used to throw StarCraft 2 GSL parties in Orlando back in 2011. That was a lot of fun and provided a lot of great memories. Now, all of you guys who listen to my cast might think, you know, I bet this guy, he's a really big fan of Shine the Zerg player. But no, I'm not a fan of Shine. I am a fan of Bisu. And let's get redundant here. My name, Bisu Dagger, stands for Assassin's Dagger Dagger. So that's obviously a tribute to my favorite player. Now, SK Telecom T1 is my favorite team also. While Bisu did play for NBC Game Hero, and I did cheer NBC Game on back then, it was really easy to transition over to cheering for SK Telecom T1 since Boxer and I Love Louvre were both players and ended up being coaches at points during their career on SK Telecom. And then, of course, Fantasy Best Bisu, being the greatest trio of all time in Brood War, made it even more fun to cheer for SK Telecom. I would want to go to Sonic and GOM XP's casting studios, and I want to be inside the player booths, be able to put on the headphones and look out into the stands. Even if the seats are empty, I don't care, I'll still get that same experience. And maybe cast an event in English if there's one available and going on while I'm in Korea. But ultimately, I'd want to be able to check out the booths, the studios, and then I would want to head straight to the beach where the StarCraft 1 Pro League Finals was played. Hundreds of thousands of seats lined up, and then fireworks going off at the same time. And coincidentally, one of our casters, Firebat Hero, for GOM TV's Classic, had a ceremony where he managed to rip off all his clothes except for his board shorts, and then he went for a ceremony where the ladies got to check him out. He got to stomp on the sand in front of everybody's faces, and great music coming in the background too. It was one of the most memorable events. And while this might hit home a little bit for Firebat Hero, I actually remember, because he won that game, I believe, against Savior, and then Much, Savior's teammate, actually went for some major revenge in his ceremony where he made this heart pylon and filled it up with photon cannons during the middle of a game versus Firebat Hero. So that was definitely one of the most memorable moments for StarCraft 1. And I'm sorry I had to bring that up again, but you guys got to check out those games if you haven't. Well, I am a staff member for Team Liquid, as you can see on my shirt here. And I manage the calendar events. I also do LiquidBet 1. So if you guys want to get more engaged in the StarCraft 1 games, there's a betting system where you can bet on your favorite teams and favorite players or who you think will ultimately win. But betting with your heart feels so much better than, you know, betting with your mind. And that scenario. And so shout out to the Team Liquid staff and the Team Liquid casters. You know, Sale is doing the Sonic Star League. So if you haven't gotten a chance to watch that yet, listen to him. He has great commentary there. And then the Team Liquid staff is so many people right now for Brood War that I really can't give accolades to everybody. But I'm grateful for the family that I've developed on that website. Like to say again, GOM, as I said, I used to throw GSL parties. I've been watching GOM events since the early 2000s, and it's really cool that you provided us with this classic tournament, but don't stop here. StarCraft 1 is popular not only in Korea, but there's a huge foreign community here. We're trying to provide our own foreign tournaments like the Team Liquid Legacy Star League, but we really want to see Korean StarCraft 1 come back to full force. So another event would be really, really great. And ultimately, I know that there's this great app that you can download to watch the games live on your Androids. If you guys not have downloaded that yet, then go ahead and get to downloading it so you can watch the events live in case you can't watch the VODs. But we would like to have live English and live Korean commentary on our desktops, so maybe a much bigger event where we're not just focused on casting from that single app would be great. And just continue to support StarCraft 1. That's all we can ask for, ultimately. And, you know, give great products to the players that participate like you did already with the GOM sweatshirts and the GOM headphones. It's just all really cool. It looks great. And so thank you very much. This is BSU Dagger talking to you guys right now. And I am the cast for GOM TV's Classic Season 4. I hope to see you guys in the finals and in future events. So please come out there and watch it. Thank you very much and take care.